Hello and welcome back guys to the second part of this tutorial, and this is where we left off in the last video. So in this video we will cover the remaining part of the HTML and the CSS. So I will here create a new file, name it second.html. so this will contain the content for the second page. So the content of this page will be loaded when we click on the next button from the first page. So let me show you what content we have on the second page. So the second page will have again the title and this button, this image, and these four collections. So all this will go into the second.html. And right now, for the sake of clarity, what I will do is write the code for the second page in the index.html itself. So I will comment out this collection wrapper class, and right here I will write the code for the second page, and when we are done we will move this to second.html. so let me create a new class here now. So here I have created a new div with the class name of container wrapper and also second page. So the class name of second page, because if you want to access any CSS specific to the second page, we can easily do that. So inside this we will have the container left and the container right, and inside the container left class we have these buttons and the text. So I have given this a class name of add button. So here right now you can see these things are added. Now we also need to add the container right class for the elements on the right of the screen. Yeah, so on the left we have the text wrapper class. Inside this we have the text and the button and also the product price. And on the next thing that we need to add here is the container right. Here I am creating a new div with a class name of container right, and inside this we will have the content and then the four product that we have on the second page. Added the div with the class name of content, and inside this I will copy the code for the background image and the four product image that we have on the second page. So here you can see I have created this class div with the class name of catalog, and inside this we have the four product image, and also on the top we have the background no image class. Inside this we will have the product.png wrapped inside the image wrapper class. So this image is this is the product.png. And next we have this div with the class name of catalog, and inside this we have four products. So I have given each them a class name of product and also first, second, third, and fourth. So these four. And now the next thing that we need to add is our social links as well as the indicators that indicates which page we are currently on. Here in this div with the class name of content bottom, we have the social links and the indicator, and this time the active is on the second div because we are on the second page. So that's all HTML we need for the second page. As you can see, we need to add CSS in order to properly see what contents we have here. So inside the second.css I will add the CSS specific to this page. So I will start with the product name and the product price. So these are nothing but simple text related CSS. So I am changing the font family, font size, color, and giving them proper margins. So as you can see, all the text are at their correct position now. So the next thing that we need to add is the add button that we have on the second page. So let me just quickly copy the code here. So for the add button, I am giving this a display of flex and aligning everything to the center. I'm giving this one a height of 40 pixels. So next thing is the add text and the add text paragraph. Let me quickly show you. So this is the add button. Inside this we have add text, add icon, and then the add inside a paragraph. So again, the font related changes for the paragraph. So the next thing that we need to add here is CSS for the add icon. So I will copy the code here. So giving this a background color and some padding. So now you see the button looks perfectly fine. So the next thing on second page is the image that we have. So I will add the CSS for my image wrapper class here. So again, position will be absolute and some left and bottom values. You can play around with these values. So the next thing is we need to adjust these images for the product that we have. So let me add some CSS for that. So for the catalog, I will give this CSS height and width will be 100%, and this grid template columns auto means, which this will be divided into 2x2 row and columns. So inside that we will have the product class. The height and width will be 100% and display flex direction will be column, and aligning everything to the center. So next we'll have the image that we have inside the product. So given this a width of 180 pixel, and some padding as well. The next thing is for the text that we have. So now you can see all these are at their correct position and the CSS have been applied properly. So we need to add some CSS for this main image. And first let me give different background color for each product that we have here. So for first, second, third and fourth, I will give them different background color. So now you can see all these four have the different background color. Now let me quickly fix the image, the main image that we have on the second page. So I will add the CSS here. So background, no image, position relative, height and width of 100%. So now it should be at its correct position. No, for some reason it is still not at its correct position. So let me quickly fix it. So the fix for that is to add this image maximum height of 500 pixel. So in the main.css you can add this. So now it will not exceed 500 pixels of height. So that's all the HTML and CSS we need for the second page. Now we need to add the HTML and CSS for this third page. So we'll have this again text and these three reviews. So first I will move all the content that we added here to the second.html. So let me quickly just cut it and paste it there. So I will paste it in my second.html file, and in the index.html file I will first write the code for the third.html and then move it to a separate file. So again I will create a new div with the class name of container wrapper, and this time I will give this again a class name of third page. So inside this third page again we will have the similar flow that we have, the container left, the container right, and inside those different contents. So first I will add the container left here. Inside this I have the class name of text wrapper, and then again the title outline, the description, and a read more button. And the next thing that we need to add here is the container right, and inside this we will have the reviews. So I will again create a new div, and for the div the class name will be again content. So let me just add it here. So I will just create a new div with the class name of content, and inside that we will have the reviews. So I have added the code for the four reviews that we have. So again the background, no image, then reviews, and the review first. And inside this we have this review image wrapper, the review content, and same for all the three reviews that we have here. And so now the next thing that we need to add on the third page is the social media links and the indicators. So let me quickly copy the code here. So here we will have the content bottom. Inside this we will have the social and the indicator, and this time the active will be on the third div because we are on the third page. So that is all the HTML required for the third page. Now I will quickly move to the CSS file. So let me show you for the third page it looks like this right now. So we need to add more CSS specific to this page. So I will move to my third.css file and add my CSS here. So the first thing that we need to add is for the description we have on the third page. So again font related changes, so this will adjust it properly. And the next thing is for the reviews. So first the reviews will have a height and width of 100%, and then flex direction column, justify content center, align items with the center. And the next thing is review. So flex one, so each review will take equal amount of space, and they have this display of flex and aligning to the center. Now for the image wrapper, I am given this a position of relative and width of 200 pixel. And for the images itself, again width of 200 pixel and object fit set to cover, so it will fit the space properly. Now the next thing is to add the CSS for the review content. So for the review content, the padding will be 0 pixel and 40 pixel. So this will give them a padding from left and right of 40 pixel. And then again font related changes for the H4, the paragraph and the H6. So this is how it looks right now. Maybe we need to increase the font a bit. So right now we also need to add the social media links and the buttons, indicator buttons. But I'm not able to see the social links and the indicator buttons, so I think I made some mistake here. So this div should be closed here, and then remove the extra closing tag that I added accidentally. Now we should be able to see this as well. So now this looks fine, and that's all the HTML and CSS we need for the third page. Now the next thing is this final page. We will have this background image and the text and the form. So first again I will move all the code that we added to the separate file, and I name this one third.html, and I will copy everything that we have written starting from this container wrapper to the third page. So I think I should also add this div closing tag as well. So let me also cut it. And in the third.html, I will paste everything along with that extra closing tag. So now let me quickly again go to the index.html and create a new div with a class name of container wrapper. And inside that, we'll have the content for the fourth page. So I will again create a new div. The class name will be container wrapper and also fourth page. So any CSS, if you want to target specific to this page, we can access using the dot fourth page. So inside again, we will have the container left and the container right. So let me quickly add the code here. So container left will again have the text wrapper class, the title, the description, and then what we have is the div with the class name of form. Now form will have the first row. Inside the first row, we will have the name and the telephone number. Then we have again an input. This time the input will be email address and then a text area. And in the bottom, we have a button. Now the next thing will be the div class container right. So on the right, we will have a background image. And inside that, we will have some text. So let me add the code here. So again, div with the class name of content, background, inside that class name of location, and then adding some text related to the location. Now this form will have this first row, then a text with email address, then a text area with your message. So next thing that we need to add here is the social media links. So right now you can see these rows that we have added and this background image. So we will need to add some CSS in order to show it properly. So here I will start off by adding some CSS for the form that we have created. So let me quickly copy the code here. So for form, the display will be flex and flex direction will be column. And then the first row will take a width of 100% and it will have a display of flex. Then we will have the CSS for, so in the first row we have two childs. So first child will have a margin right of 10 pixel and the second child will have a margin left of 10 pixel. Then some styling for the input and the text area, giving them proper padding, borders and the font. So now you can see everything looks fine. So inside this first row, this have a margin right and this one have a margin left. Next thing that we need to adjust is our image, background image that we have. So let me write the code for that here. So for the location, I'm giving this one a width and height of 100%, then a display of flex, and then aligning and justifying content of center and flex direction column, and then some font related changes for the H4 span, and the paragraph. So now this should be centered into the background image that we have. So let me show you that. So now this looks fine. Now the next thing I think we need to add is the indicators and the social links. So again, inside the index.html file, we need to add the content bottom. Let me quickly add that here. So here will be the content bottom with a div class social and the indicator. And this time the active will be on the last div because we are on the last page. So we are done with these HTML and CSS for the last page. So that's all HTML and CSS we need for this project. In the next video, we will cover the JavaScript part. We'll give functionality to the next and the previous button to change the page, and also we'll add the animation. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next one.